Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to spell out text inside objects. For your convenience, I provided this image that you can download for this project. Its link is in my video's description or project files. If you are using this banana image, you can skip the next few steps. If you're using an image that's not on a white background, open your Quick Selection tool and click the Select Subject button to make a selection around it. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask next to the layer. Make a new layer below it by Control or Command clicking the New Layer icon. Fill it with white by pressing Shift plus the F5 key at the top of your keyboard or by going to Edit and Fill. This will open the Fill window. Open the Contents list and click White. Click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Flatten Image. Open your Horizontal Type tool and Type Picker. Pick a heavy font since this will give us the best result. I'm picking Bebas New Regular. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link as well. For this example, the size of my text is 435 points. However, if you're using a different font or a different object, feel free to adjust its size. The aliasing is smooth and center alignment. The color of the text is irrelevant as long as we can see it over the object. Click on your document and type out the text. We want the characters to be very close to each other. To adjust the space between all the characters, known as tracking, highlight the text and press Alt or Option and the right or left arrow key on your keyboard. If you want to reposition one character, known as kerning, place your cursor to the left of that character and repeat the keystroke. We'll convert our text into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. To do this, open your Move tool, click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel, and click Convert to Smart Object. We'll begin to warp our text by pressing Ctrl or Command T to open the Transform tool. Click the Warp Transform icon, which places a grid over our text. Open the Warp list and click Arc. We want the arc to bend the other way. Next to bend, type in minus 45. To rotate it, open your transform tool, go to a corner, and rotate it counterclockwise to match the arc of the top of the object. Reposition and re-angle it until the top of the text extends just past the top of the object. Press Enter or Return twice, or click the check mark at the top. We'll convert this manipulated text into another smart object so we can warp it further in its present shape. Open your Transform tool and click the Warp Transform icon. Open the grid list and click 3x3. We want to manipulate the bottom of our text so it extends a bit past the bottom of the object. Drag the control points, segments of the bounding box, or areas within the mesh. When adjusting curves, use the control point handles. Then press Enter or Return twice. We'll add a new layer below the object. To do this, click the Lock icon to unlock the layer, and as before, Control or Command click the New Layer icon. We'll fill it with white. Instead of filling it with a fill window, I'll show you another way to do it. Check your foreground and background colors. If they aren't black and white, press D on your keyboard or click this icon. If they're reversed, press X or click this icon. We'll fill our empty layer with the background color by pressing Ctrl or Command plus Delete. Ctrl or Command click the thumbnail of your text to select its shape. Hide the text and make the object active. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection next to the active layer. The reason we're seeing our object in the shape of our text is because in layer masks, white reveals the image next to it, and black conceals the rest of it. Reverse the colors. Open the Pencil tool and Pencil Picker. Pick a hard, round point. We'll adjust its size in a moment. Its opacity is 100%. To make the pencil point bigger or smaller, make sure the Caps Lock key is off and press the left or right bracket key on your keyboard. Draw over the left and right sides of the object to reveal the image through the layer mask. Lastly, we'll add a soft shadow under it. Make a new layer. Open your brush tool and make sure black is your foreground color. Open the brush picker and pick a soft round brush. Make the size 400 pixels. The hardness is 0% and the opacity and flow are 100%. Place your brush just below the bottommost part of the subject and click once. Open your transform tool and press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag the transform's bounding box out approximately this much. Go to the top or bottom of the bounding box, and again, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in approximately this much. Drag it below the object, then press Enter or Return. Reduce its opacity to 40%. We can raise or lower it at any time by pressing and holding the Shift key as you press the up or down arrow on your keyboard. Pressing Shift moves it 10 pixels at a time. Double-click the shadow layer to open its layer style window. Click Color Overlay. The blend mode is normal. Click the color box, and for this example, I'll type into the hexadecimal field 6, 1, 3, 8, 0, 1. This gives the shadow a warm tint. Then press Enter or Return twice to close both windows. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.